will like Delsey's new Easy Open Package and Easy Start First Sheet. Soft Delsey bathroom tissue makes life a little easier.
A definite difference in Delsey.
Ladies and gentlemen, the history of rock and roll, 136 seconds from now.
Scotty Brink, 93KHJ.
Baby, is he looking after you? Is he showing you the same love, a warm love, just like we knew? Baby, baby, it's you I'm thinking of. I'm thinking of you.
During the next 3 days, you will experience the history of rock and roll, the sounds of the birth and development of a musical revolution. The staff and management of KHJ Los Angeles take great pride in presenting
the history of rock and roll.
Trash, or you don't get those pending cash. up above. And you would tell me I'm the only one that you love. Life would be a dream. Sweetheart, hello, hello again.
I went to the window and peeked through the blind and asked him to tell me what was on his mind. He said,
has taken us back 15 years to the seedling age of rock and roll. The records from which these excerpts were taken will be heard in full during the KHJ Rockumentary. Some ingredients of rock and roll sprouted in the 1950s, but others had already been a long time growing. In the beginning, there was gospel, a blend of the rhythms of Africa, church teachings, and a people's need for musical expression. From it branched the blues, then rhythm and blues, each individual, but each resembling its parent.
Heal the sick! Heal the sick! Heal the sick! Heal that man! Heal that woman! Heal, Lord!
My clothes,
Sonny Boy Williamson.
Now I done fool around in Chicago. Yank, I done almost froze.
Tampa Red.
Little minnows in the river. In the deep blue sea. Little minnows in the river. Kingfish in the deep blue sea. Lord, I got a gang of women crying to get a chance with me.
Thank you.
possess the cornerstones of bass, harmony, and emotion. The foundation of a revolutionary music which became the heartbeat and anthem of the 20th century.
In the beginning, there was nothing but rock. Then somebody invented the wheel. And things just began to roll.
The wheel which started rocks rolling was made of an alloy strong enough to trundle the music from its sectional appeal to universal popularity. One element of this alloy was country music, another was traditional pop, and a third was folk. But the backbone of this old new music of the early 50s was rhythm and blues, and the Clovers were one of the earliest R&B groups. One of their records, in fact, introduced the saxophone to rhythm and blues. Ahmet Erdogan, then and now president of Atlantic Records, who wrote this number one record from the summer of 1951, describes its making.
Vocal groups in the early days could never use anything but a rhythm section, right?
Can't you see what you're doing to me?
I thought you know I love you, love so. Don't you know I love you so. Don't you know I love you so. And I'll never, never let you go.
Because the rhythm section, I wanted to use Frank Cully's rhythm section, Frank Cully, the saxophone player who recorded for us. And he told me he wouldn't let me use his rhythm section unless I paid him double scale. So I said, okay, then you have to play. He said, what am I going to play? I said, I don't know, we have to play something. That was Chris Clover's record, and it had no bass on it because the bass player didn't show up. But as a result, the guitar player played a bass line along with a piano player, and it worked out very well, uncluttered, you know. It was a big hit and established the group. And it was called Don't You Know I Love You.
History of Rock and Roll continues in a moment with the first hit from 1953 of a group which had more than a dozen years of successful records.
Ladies, listen to this amazing fabric offer from Sears. Right now you can save 50% on five of Sears' best-selling drapery fabrics. These are Sears' best-selling fabrics at the regular price of $4 a yard. But the price has been cut in half for this sale. So, you will pay only $2 a yard. Your choice of fabrics ranges from ultra-fancy to handsome casual stylings, and there are 60 beautiful decorator colors. Here's an example of the money you can save during Sears' fabulous half-price drapery sale. The regular cost for one of these fine fabrics, including the custom workmanship on 12-foot by 95-inch ceiling-to-floor draperies, is $122. But you'll save a big $48 at Sears' fabric sale price of just $74. Call Sears today. Save 50% on Sears' best-selling drapery fabrics. Custom traverse rods and installation available. Pay no money down on Sears' easy payment plan. But hurry, this great sale ends soon. All Sears stores open till 9:30 p.m.
When fever blisters and cold sores are a real problem, when they dry, crack, and hurt so badly they bring tears to your eyes, you need Camphophenique. For this soothing liquid antiseptic penetrates deep, so the fever blister or cold sore dries and heals quickly and painlessly from underneath. And Camphophenique lubricates and softens fever blisters to prevent painful cracking. Yes, you'll say Camphophenique is wonderful for fast healing of fever blisters and cold sores. Get Camphophenique.
The history of rock and roll.
Tell me what was on his mind. I said, "My honey, yes, my honey, my honey. If you wanna stay here with me, I was lean and keen and so hard pressed. I called the woman that I love best. I finally got my baby by the hand past three. She said, 'I'd like to know what you want with me.'"
After Clyde McFatter and the Drifters came out with Money Honey was marked by a song which has frequently been pegged as the first rock and roll record. The Crew Cuts covered it, but the original version of Shaboom was by the Chords.
Life could be a dream, life could be a dream. Do, 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 Shaboom. Life could be a dream. Shaboom. If I could take you up in paradise up above. Shaboom. And you would tell me I'm the only one that you love. Life could be a dream. Sweetheart, hello, hello again. Shaboom, and open with me again. Boom, boom, ding, 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 ding
dip, a dip, a dip, a dip. Oh, life could be a dream. If only all my precious plans would come true. If you would let me spend my whole life loving you, life would be a dream, sweetheart.
Every time I look at you, something is all my mind. If you knew what I want you to, maybe we'd be so fine.
Oh, life would be a dream. Shaboom, if I could take you up in paradise up above. Shaboom, you know me, darling, I'm the only one that you love. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. I know how long it. Shaboom, you know for me to get home. Oh, life would be a dream. Life would be a dream, sweetheart.
The early 50s produced flocks of groups named after birds, among them the Orioles, the Flamingos, the Penguins, the Robins, the Wrens, the Meadowlarks, and the Cardinals. The Spaniels led a mild revolt against this feathered trend, but it didn't taper down until several years later, perhaps killed by Stan Freberg's satirical formation of a group called the Toads. Meanwhile, though, back in 1954, one of the biggest records of the year was a song called G, performed by a group named the Crows.
Yeah.
1954 was the year of another rhythm and blues landmark in the KHJ history of rock and roll, a record which used the traditional blues structure of verse, repeat verse, and answer line. For example, get out of that bed, wash your face and hands, get out of that bed, wash your face and hands, while you get in that kitchen, make some noise with pots and pans. The original version of Shake, Rattle, and Roll was sung by Joe Turner, a piano-playing blues singer from Kansas City who had first come to prominence in the 1930s. He was 43 years old when Shake, Rattle, and Roll turned him into a rock and roll star. Joe Turner's version, though, was outsold by a cover record, a later copy of the song by a Philadelphia country and western singer, Bill Haley. Cover records of rhythm and blues songs, or race records as they were called in the late 40s and early 50s, were common. The Crew Cuts, the Diamonds, and several other groups made careers with pale cover versions of R&B hits. Jerry Lieber, who teamed with Mike Stoller to write dozens of rhythm and blues hits, including all the Coasters records and Hound Dog by Elvis Presley, has several thoughts about why cover records were common and why blues and rhythm and blues songs often did not make the pop hit parade.
Blues was considered déclassé. It was considered, I don't know, dirty music. And a lot of the records, the early days, were called race records. And a lot of the lyrics were double entendre. And a lot of the artistic value or cultural value that rested in a lot of that music was totally ignored because of just existing mores and attitudes. And so a lot of it was ridiculed and condemned.
And piano of a man whose first hit record was in 1949 and whose last hit record was in 1968. In 2 minutes, as KHJ Los Angeles turns more pages in the history of rock and roll.
Every cut of meat you choose is yours, and your money talks louder. treat on pork chops. The ribeye cut of pork chops, meaty and delicious, is just 59 cents a pound. That's Safeway, where you always save money and get blue chip stamps, too.
Safeway has more of what you're in the market for.
High-fashion, high-volume price cutter like the Standard Shoe Store organization has problems, especially when they have to keep moving out all 50,000 pairs of shoes at each of their six stores to keep them in style all the time. Until 12 months ago, women bought certain staple shoe styles over and over. When the stock in a particular shoe ran low, Standard Shoes simply reordered the colors and sizes they had sold. Not in 1969, though. Styles now change overnight. If a shoe sells slowly, they dump it. Or if it sells quickly, it's often impossible to reorder the colors and styles they had sold out of. So they dumped the remaining odds and ends. From now on, at each of the six Standard Shoe stores, you'll find one corner proclaimed a disaster area by the president. The president of Standard Shoes, that is. They're all marked out anywhere from $1 to, in many cases, half the usual Standard Shoe store's cut prices. Now, look for the cleanup markdown corner whenever you visit a Standard Shoe store.
The history of rock and roll.
We'll call, and even if night, I hurry to my heaven. On Saturday night, where I was born, I got a whole lot of love for you, true love for you. This time I'm walking to New Orleans. Hello, Josephine.
Fats Domino was born on February 26, 1928, in New Orleans, the home of Dixieland Jazz and of a distinctive brand of blues. He was discovered in 1948 by a talent scout from Imperial Records, one of the early rhythm and blues labels. He told the man he didn't think he could sing and didn't know if he could write a song. Fats Domino discussed his early days as a performer recently for the KHJ History of Rock and Roll.
My real name is Antoine Domino. I started in the band about 17. Then I was working 3 nights a week in New Orleans. The first record I made about 3 weeks before Christmas of 49, it was called A Fat Man, sold over a million and a half. It was called Rhythm and Blues then. My first pop record that the all radio station played, I think, was Ain't That a Shame.
You made me cry when you said goodbye.
Goodbye.
Ain't That a Shame was a hit from 1955. It kicked off a golden period for Fats Domino, who was already well-established at that time. One of the biggest hits from his rhythm and blues period came in 1953, a record which he remembers he did in one take, producing a finished version after only one playthrough in the studio.
One song I made, one thing was called Please Don't Leave Me. I didn't do much singing in it. When I mean it, my wife said, what's the matter? The guy said, she said, why are you trying to sing? I said, I was tired. She said, well, the lady she told me, she said, I wish you could make another one like that. But I think that was something about maybe meaning something.
In conjunction with Dave Bartholomew, and many of them shared a common element. They were based on everyday phrases. This is true of the first two Fats Domino records we played, Ain't That a Shame and Please Don't Leave Me, and is also true of million sellers such as I'm in Love Again, Poor Me, Don't Blame It on Me, and Going Home. It also applies to the next Fats Domino record from the year 1956, Blue Monday, which we'll hear after Fats discusses some other elements of his sound.
I didn't know too much about music when I first started, but I went after. You know, I got everything from New Orleans. Some called rock and roll, different name. I just call it music with a beat. You got to have that beat, something that's feeling, and something that you feel. But you got to really feel it to produce it. When I write songs, I get the melody first. I give me a catchy melody. Then you can write the story from the melody.
My gal called, got to tell her that I'm
ain't that a shame, the year 1955 was highlighted by the first rhythm and blues ballad to dent the pop record charts. Cashbox magazine, a record industry trade paper, reported that it was the 33rd best-selling record of the year, while the cover version by the Crew Cuts came in at number 35. The record was Earth Angel, sung originally by the Penguins. Documentary continues with a giant 1955 hit by the Moonglows.
Escape! Come over to Royal Crown Cola!
Meredith McRae, an exciting new television star, a real comer. Now meet another comer, RZ. It's moving up fast in popularity, catching on all over the country. Get with the comer. Get with RZ.
Good things come in small packages from Langendorf, including delicious Langendorf snacks. Look for the Mickey on the label, then try a banana cream sandwich or cream-filled Twinettes. Your choice of cream-filled cupcakes, too. Walnut banana, applesauce, and dark devil's food. They're all so good. Look for the Mickey on the label. Famous snacks from Langendorf. Take the advice of some successful men down in Vernon, California, who know how to live high on the hog. These master butchers and sausage makers at Lure Packing Company can take a corn-fed Iowa porker and turn him into a variety of tasty treats for your table. Now you can live high on the hog, too. Just reach for Lure's ham, bacon, frankfurters, pork links, or luncheon meats. Look for the Lure label and put quality on your table.
Every day's a special day. Yes, every day's a special day. Every day's a special day. A Thrifty Mart. The history of rock and roll.
Yeah.
Sincerely was co-written by the lead singer for the Moonglows, Harvey Fuqua, and disc jockey Alan Freed, who was credited with coining the term rock and roll. The song was covered at the time by the McGuire sisters, just as the next song on the KHJ History of Rock and Roll was covered. In this case, the cover artist was Georgia Gibbs, whose version of Tweedledee outsold the Vern Baker's original record because of the barriers to pure rhythm and blues. But here is one of the largest records of Laverne Baker's career. Also the beginning of one of the most successful groups in the early days of rock and roll, the Platters, whose first gold record was Only You. Chicago blues singer with a flair for modifying guitars adapted the shave and a haircut two bits rhythm to a folk song to come up with a stage name for himself.
As strange as it may seem, I used to be a little, you know, if I may so say so, a little jive fighter, you know. And it was beginning to look pretty good for me, but I preferred like another type of entertainment. In other words, entertaining the people. And so I got started on beating and banging on my axe a little bit more, and so up popped Bo Diddley.
Also the title of his largest single from 1955.
Don't let it bite, baby, diamond ring. If that diamond ring don't shine, he gonna take it to a private eye. If that private eye can't see, he better take the ring from me.
Himself backstage at a concert playing Russian roulette. He had had hits before, but his romantic death made him the first rock and roll idol and propelled his next release into becoming his most successful record, Pledging My Love. The year was 1955.
Just you. Just
1 minute, the history of rock and roll continues on KHJ Los Angeles with Ray Charles.